The new anti-terror law was just passed in the Philippines, which critics argue is bad news for human rights and freedom of speech. If you're protesting or speak against the government, could you be charged as a terrorist and potentially face lifetime imprisonment without parole under the new law? To find out, we invited two prominent Filipino lawyers with different positions on this law to discuss how it might impact average Filipino citizens.
Maraming salamat po sa pakisama niyo sa interview at oras ngayon sa amin. Today, we're here to discuss the anti-terrorism law, and we have here attorney Bruce Rivera and attorney Howard Calleja to get different perspectives on this terrorism law with two different lawyers. To your understanding, what exactly is the anti-terror law? Why should people even care about this? How will this affect normal citizens?
The anti-terror law is a law that is made by, you know, by the state, the Philippine state, that is to protect the common welfare and the safety of its people. Terror is more difficult to, you know, to prosecute, to know and to discover, and we have to be steps ahead of the terrorists. That's why this law was created, because to answer to our needs. And the statements and the prodding of the international community and the states, the Western states, for us to have a law that is comparable to theirs in fighting terrorism.
When you first heard that this law was passed, what was your immediate reaction?
Of course, my immediate reaction was maybe it's about time, because I think we all know that the Philippines is ranked ninth in the most terrorist driven or terrorist affected country in the world, even if we're, you know, such a speck, just a speck in the map. So I think maybe perhaps it was a welcome legislation, but of course I expected it to cause an uproar in our community, especially when we are very concerned with individual human rights.
Although we agree that we need a law against terrorism, we need a good law that is consistent with the Constitution. That's why immediately July 4, we filed a petition for certiorari in our court, meaning we questioned the constitutionality of this law with a temporary restraining order in the hope that our Supreme Court will stop the effectivity of this law, because we feel that since it is obviously on its face unconstitutional because of the wordings and how this law is written.